What is up, everybody? It's HomiesOfMars back again today with another comparison video. Now, if you're wondering why I'm doing this comparison video on the private server, I usually do my comparison videos on actual RotMG, like the production game, because, you know, I actually usually have the character or the items to do it, but unfortunately my knight died like a few weeks ago. I can't even remember now. It's been maybe a month now. Yeah, he died, and I haven't made another one since. And I just felt like, well, we can do it easier here. I just made up a knight right here, and you know, he has Colossus shield versus Ogmur. All right, so you have your tier 6 shield, which Colossus is great. All right, it's one of the few abilities. Like if you look at tier 5 and tier 6 abilities, pretty much every single class, the only difference between them is usually the fact that the tier 6 ability gives 2 vitality and 2 wisdom. And that's the only difference between tier 6 and tier 5. But the Colossus Shield, not only does it give 2 vitality and 2 wisdom, but it actually does do a tiny bit more damage than the Mithril Shield. I think the Mithril Shield does like... here, we can go ahead and give it... Alright, so if you look at the Mithril Shield, you can tell there's a difference. Alright, 270 to 330, and this does 300 to 360. So the damage is different, and the only other thing that's different is the fact that the Colossus Shield gives 2 vitality and 2 wisdom. And of course, you know, the fame bonus is different. But so it actually is worth buying a tier 6 shield over a tier 5 shield, because it actually does more damage just a little bit, and you know, usually the vitality and wisdom, which is nice. Now, the Colossus Shield is your standard shield, like every other shield except for Ogmur. Colossus does, it stuns the enemy for 3.5 seconds. That is the biggest thing about the knight. You know, you can stun enemies and you can sit on top of them. It is so fun doing. You know, going up to Orcs 2 and stunning him in the face is always rejuvenating, and stuff like that. And it allows for every other player that's around you. The knight is almost, in a way, a support class. I mean, for the fact it stuns enemies, and so it really makes killing orcs too really easy. Now, shield of Ogmur, all right. This is a unique shield, and at the same time, it gives you the ability to really dish out some damage. Of course, the range of these shields are both the same, 3.2. And instead of stunning, this shield armor breaks for 4 seconds. So instead of 3.5, which is a normal stun, it's a 4 second armor break. And it gives you 2 more defense, and it gives you 60 HP, which the Colossus Shield doesn't give you any HP. So I'm going to put it on. I get 2 more defense, as you can see, but no vitality and wisdom bonuses. And don't pay attention to these numbers. It's just, I'm on a private server, so this isn't actually the real game. But anyways, Colossus Shield is really useful. It's especially useful when you're by yourself, but if you have somebody else with a shield that can stun, I mean, really, even if it's just a Mithril shield, a reliable person, might I add, you can put on the Ogmur an armor break, so it's the enemy is stunned and he's armor broken, so that gives you a huge amount of, you know, especially on things with, you know, a lot of defense, alright, especially orcs, obviously. So if you have one person stunning, the other person doing the Ogmur, it's like armor broken, the enemy can't shoot you, and it's just a crap load of damage going to him, because really you don't have to do much but just sit there and hurt the enemy. It's really useful on the Stone Guardians. You know, if you look at a video comparing somebody just using Colossus or a video using somebody using Ogmur, you can tell the Stone Guardians go down a lot faster, because you know they have 100 defense and that cancels out a ton of damage. But giving the effect of armor broken really, really helps. And you see, here's the thing: the Ogmur actually can be useful on the Stone Guardians. You don't, even if you're like the only knight there, you know, you really don't have to worry about them doing too much damage to you, because the Stone Guardians don't do a ton of damage to really any max knight. So if you just use the Ogmur the whole time, it works wonders, especially if you're really wanting to go as fast as possible. The Ogmur also does help on tombs, and of course I really definitely recommend that you have another knight stunning. You know, let the knight stun, then you go in and do the armor break, and that, boom, I mean, those tomb bosses will be down, especially if you have a warrior and a paladin. That is a dreamland right there. But Ogmur is basically the key to really taking down enemies that have a high amount of defense. Now, Ogmur is not useful in Godlands really at all. It just I mean, yeah, you can take down the enemy pretty fast, but I'd use Colossus in Godlands if I were you. You know, Colossus is the thing to do, because, you know, if you have, like, a big wall of gods, you just run up to the gods, stun them, and sit in the middle of them. It's great. Make sure you stand there just enough time, because you don't want to, you know, have them unstun and then, like, hurt you. But, again, Ogmur is really good for dungeons, depending on the boss. And it's especially if you have somebody else stunning, like Archdemon Malphus, yeah. I can't say words, but use Ogmur and then use Colossus with your friend. And, I mean, Colossus and an Ogmur combo is just a deadly combo. I mean, that's about as bad as it gets for the enemy. I mean, it's pretty scary to see how much damage you can do. But don't want to event with Ogmur, even if it's... I mean, yeah, you could if the other person was stunning, but personally, if I'm eventing, I would just use Colossus the whole way. Anything really in the realm, for that matter. I mean, especially Grand Sphinx. Do not use Ogmur to Grand Sphinx, unless you're with a group again, but Colossus is great for anything in the realm. But Ogmur can do... It's great for anything that's, you know, like a sprite world. I mean, you can take Lyman down. I mean, Lyman doesn't have as much health as it is, but using the Ogmur on Lyman just makes the sprite world really easy to farm. I mean, you can run through these things as fast as you can. So, basically, I'm saying here, guys, is if you have to choose one of them, obviously, bring your Colossus. But the Ogmur is just a great addition. It's, and of course, it gives you the 6% fame bonus, so... You know, if you're planning on dying, die with Ogmur. But, I mean, how many of us plan to die? Not very many. But, again, it's not needed to have Ogmur, but it's great to have it. If you're going to be a good knight, all the good knights are carrying Ogmur. I mean, that's just the great shield. I mean, these shields are great to use together. I think it's definitely worth it having Ogmur. If you actually were on the fence, like, I don't know if I want to buy Ogmur or not, go ahead and buy it. I mean, even if you just have the Mithril Shield, buy Ogmur, because it's worth buying. It's fun using. It's a great shield, and that's pretty much it today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, the comparison guide. If you guys have any different opinions about this, go ahead and put them in the description. But, the comment section, you can't edit the description. But, again, be careful, though, with Ogmur, because... If you accidentally have that shield on and you're going to go stun orcs too and you're the only one stunning, don't want to have Ogmur on because you can take a shotgun. So make sure you know your range with a shield. Again, if you're ever using a shield, guys, you know, some people will get like really close to orcs too. He'll be over here and they try to stun. It's like, oh, just off, and then they, you know, get killed. So make sure you get familiar with what 3.2 range is. Because I know I've seen plenty of people just barely miss a stun and then die from it. It's a sad way to see that go. And always use your best judgment. Don't go in on Oryx 2 unless you feel completely comfortable with it, because Oryx 2 and Tomb Bosses are really the only thing that the Knight has to worry about. Or, again, you know, getting armor broken. That's really it. I mean, other than that, the Knight is pretty much invincible, and then it's a very fun class. But anyways, guys, hope you have a good rest of the day, and go ahead and put another thing you want me to do comparison guide over. Anything, abilities, and I'm thinking about doing a class, like you know, class versus class, or something like that. Priest versus Necromancer, stuff like that. I haven't decided, I'm going to start that one. I don't need a recommendation for that. I'll go ahead and start that myself, but I will start that up a little bit later. Right now, I'm just... focus on doing other stuff, but yeah, anything like abilities, weapons, rings, armor, light armor, robes, go ahead and put that in the description, I mean the comments section, and go ahead and give me a recommendation, and the most liked will always be the one that I do next. So I hope you guys have a good rest of the day, and I'll see you guys later.